When we got to the mainland, we found the space elevator's support facility. I guess this was the factory where they built the gigantic structure the elevator traveled in. There was this little girl sitting in front of a mural. When the princess saw her, she shuddered like she'd seen a ghost. The girl had a stuffed animal. This was the day after the shit went down at Tyler Island. She walked right up to the princess, took her hand, and led her into the factory. One thing's for sure, they knew each other. The factory had been converted to a production line for Illusion drones. It was fully automated and chugging along, making drone after drone after drone. Once they got inside, the princess stopped and just stood there.
Saya!
Another girl was there with a man in a lab coat. He was trying to use his keyboard, but she wouldn't let him. She took a data chip and threw it on the ground. Then she walked over to us and took the gun from the prison guard's holster. She pulled the trigger and destroyed the chip. Later, I found out that the girl with the gun and the one with the stuffed animal were sisters. They were also the granddaughters of Mihai A. Shilaji, the legendary pilot. Gramps used to talk about him. He said Mihai was the top ace from 2 wars ago. Know any Belkans? Because this guy was a Belkan, and they love to stir shit up. Pitting nations against other nations is a particular favorite of theirs, along with developing hyper-advanced technology.
That's right. I'm Belkan, born and raised. My country is gone now. Rather than surrender to its enemy, Belka detonated 7 nuclear weapons on its own soil. My people scattered around the globe, living in the shadows of other countries. We had a new purpose, to breed wars. The theory was that through war, we could achieve our destiny and our revenge. I had just finished inputting Mihai's data when his granddaughter came in. She destroyed the only copy I had of the information I squeezed out of him. The girl loved Mihai. No one knew more than her just how hard I pushed her grandfather for that data, how much I made him sacrifice in the process. I promised his granddaughters that his efforts were not in vain, that it could end this terrible war. But in the end, it only caused more chaos and despair. We were responsible for all this damage, all this tragedy. Now, we were going to pay for it. The Arusians, once our allies, would see to that. I had lost the drive to continue my work, even before I noticed Mihai's granddaughters eyeing me with suspicion that one day. I should have stopped then, for all our sakes. Mihai's granddaughter tossed the gun aside. She said if she resorted to killing, she'd just end up like the rest of us. And by us, she meant everyone, including the princess. Like me, the princess was afraid to look into the girl's eyes. She knew that by encouraging her people, she kept the war going. Mihai and his granddaughter were victims of it. Now, they too were paying the price.
Is this for Belka? Or for Arusia? My grandfather had only one wish, to continue soaring through the endless skies. Country to call home.
Strike this!
The Black Forest, the lake, they are no longer
you got...
Even though those lands were once cherished by my late mother,
you're no good match for the future.
We have to put that sense of nostalgia behind us and behave like mature adults.
Remember the path of the future.
My homeland. She's right. It feels so far away now.
Curses.
The woman with the rifle approached me. She was focused on more pressing issues.
I checked the computer. All of the data on the legendary ace had already been installed.
No, I pulled it before it was completed. However, there are two aircraft that are already scheduled to be manufactured based on that data.
We must destroy the factory.
This isn't the only one. There are more facilities just like it. And the two planes containing the data will be manufactured at one of those facilities.
So, this place runs on solar power that the space elevator generates, right? How about the others? We can destroy the space elevator and cut the power to them. First things first, let's take this one out.
I'll show you which locations to target.
I stood there, thinking about that mural by the factory's entrance. Harling commissioned it to be painted. I realized that in the background, behind the dancing figures, the artist had painted several space elevators. I understand now. The space elevator wasn't designed to exploit Erugia after all. And afterwards, we'll bring down the space elevator itself. No matter why it was built, right now is the root of this chaos.
Electromagnetic.
Which path you would choose?
Electromagnetic.
When looking at Harling's mirror.
20 skeleton 9.
Let's get the breathing started.
Done enough air operations. Just let us go home.
There's no path for us to get home. Whatever direction you fly, you'll be right into a hail of enemy fire. Earlier, we received a communication via the partially restored general network. Here is what it contained. Apparently, the Erugian radicals have gathered around the space orb. As it's a source of energy, give the warmongers powerful energy source, and you give them the luxury to keep on fighting. In response to this, people from both Osea and Erugia have joined forces and will take down the final arsenal bird in a saturation attack from the air. Once that's achieved, they'll take the space elevator from the aggressors.
Has the source been verified?
It could be fake. I hear you. Take a look at what's written at the end. Hey, dumbass. You want to bring the world back from the brink, go to the light and see the future.
Dumbass? Sounds familiar.
Certainly does. It's from those guys we met in Tyler Island. The 444 Squad. It's a message to all those looking to end the war. But I also think it's a message for Trigger.
Guess we'll do what it says.
Okay. Well, then I'm thinking we go roast that damn bird.
Looks like we're all on the same page. It's time to end this war. Time to fly, guys. Let's go get that arsenal bird.
All right, let's go, arsenal bird.
Sortie ASAP.
Damn girl, damn. Damn girl, damn girl, damn. Die! Try not to lose your eyes. Hold it back up. Damn girl, yeah!
Continuing above the horizon.
got some pushing me to the fight! You gotta stop them. Getting my nerve.
We're nearing 0 hour. 10 seconds until the united attack of the Arsenal Bird. Help! Oh, shit!
kill him!
Ah!
anywhere.
I knew you could do it. Move out and destroy the rest.
And this fight. Fucking destroy now.
Docking module destroyed. That's two of them.
That's two of them.
Thank you. Lieutenant makes you to confirm destroyed.
Forecaster! Oh my god! The arsenal burn is on fire!
Trigger, break off. Arsenal burn is losing altitude rapidly.
Forecaster, can you estimate the point of impact?
Looks like it'll be over water. All aircraft, avoid the target's path.
That's the last of the rogues. Even in death, that thing is intimidating.
Everyone, can you see this? These people here were alive up until a few moments ago. My friend is here. Can you see this? This is just one of the many sides of war and what it does.
Hell, I can't just snap my fingers and make a plane. Believe me, I wish I could. Right now, we need it. When we were coming over on the boat, I remember seeing an aircraft carrier. That gave me an idea. The Admiral Anderson. The name of an old sailor. When the first drone started attacking, the ship wasn't ready for battle yet. It was still in the dock, getting all rigged up. So they rushed to get her ready. I know about Anderson. In the previous Ocean War, he was the commander of the ship that sent out the last fleet of jets. They say the deck was slipping so bad as it sank, the last plane barely made it off. Those fighters ended the war. That story gives me a little bit of hope, especially at a time like this. We're all in the same boat, like it or not. If this war keeps going on like it is,
they got me through this. Set me trying to draw my line. Baby, I know something else. I'm not listening when you say goodbye.
The hangars were loaded with goodies.
Dark blue.
Trigger, everyone, listen up. The operation was a success. Erujian defense forces have been neutralized and all Arsenal birds are down. However, those two new drones buzzing around have royally screwed up our plans. The Ocean and Erujian Coalition's air forces are in a sorry state thanks to them. We might not even have any viable aircraft. According to the Scrap Queen, the drones are trying to use the space elevator's transmission capabilities to send their data to drone manufacturing plants across the continent. They're trying to strengthen their numbers. What's worse, their data contains a depth of war experience. The newer aircraft will be more tactically advanced. If that's the case, this war will never end. We need to take both drones down no matter what it takes.
No matter what it takes! So we have to finish to go the back. Fight.
Well, the Scrap Queen's on our side. She says she can make any aircraft fly. This is our final mission.
All right,
Trigger,
this is fine.
Go. We've got a goddamn war to end.
Commence mission. All aircraft follow Trigger.
Roger that. Understood.
All right.
Understood. Roger.
Space elevator is able to broadcast and communicate. The information infrastructure down is the only place capable of wide area data transmission. The drones are waiting for it to power up again.
Clever little bastards.
All aircraft converge on Skull Squadron. Surround and shut down.
Rider 3, copy. Let's do it, Lucian.
UAV reacting. Damn, they're fast. All aircraft stay sharp. Intercept now.
Trigger to score a kill. Hell yeah! You finally did!
It's a scarlet of the wings.
It's just like a UAV the Trigger shot down at Fort Everest. Is that the prototype that Wiseman was talking about?
Eyes open.
Lion triggered too much. He's gonna need help.
You can't be serious, Count.
Yeah, well, you had no problem with Trigger doing the same thing.
Trigger's different.
We'll see.
You damn fool.
Stop.
Don't worry. I learned something from my last squadron. Stick with Trigger, and you'll make it.
Stay with me, please.
Count, give me your status.
Alive.
Excellent. So you're both okay.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What makes you think that?
No time to explain. The radio will cut out soon. It'll take a short time for the drone to send over the data. You need to destroy it as fast as you can.
There it is! UAV spotted. We finally found it.
Oh,
I thought we were gonna pull
this off after making through that maze. Don't worry, I'll think of something. I'll find us a way out. They're waiting for you outside. I'm not gonna let you drop here. No sign of the drone. Did it take another path? Doesn't matter. We know where it's going. We can catch it.
Strong and fast.
I'm not getting much thrust, but I'll be okay.
Don't let anyone do it. Oh, man,
that's
quite
the problem.
Get out of here. Everyone is waiting for you.
I'm about to wait until I have less fuel, but I have no choice. Attempting to land. I don't think my plane will make it. Anyway, here goes. Come on, baby. Stay with me just a bit more.
Something. What color is the sky up there?
be the first to land.
Wait, what was that transmission?
This is Captain K. Nagase of the spaceship Pilgrim 1. The ocean of stars in our galaxy is finally within our reach. To the pilot who generously gave this spaceship a place to dock, we are forever grateful. The universe lies ahead of us, waiting to be discovered. And now, at last, we have a gateway to ascend to it, over and over again.
It's all coming together for me. Today was the day, the moment of her return.
I salute the pilot who gave us all a future.
Unknown. The path to mankind's vast future remains standing, Granddad. The refugees built the settlement for themselves at the base of the space elevator. A humanitarian mission from Yukduvania airdropped some supplies for them again today. Thanks to the princess, the whole world was pitching in to help these people. Handing out the relief supplies would have been a perfect gig for that anarchist dude. But since he's dead now, the job went to the guy from Belka, George. I guess Tabloid got that new system he wanted in the end. Mihai's granddaughters are helping out too. Mihai. That cranky old geezer's here with us too.
I never wanted to create anything, and now here I am, clinging to life. Watching as my grandchildren and their generation make a new future for themselves and the world. Is this my punishment then? All I do is lie here, wasting energy. I'll never know the freedom of flying the open skies ever again. I've been grounded, and my wings have been clipped.
You know what having peace in the world means? It's being able to die in your own bed at a ripe old age. Peace is what those girls are working so hard for here. We got a bunch more refugees today. And the princess, she's looking to the stars. Dark blue, to the heavens and beyond.
context what happens to future, to create a new world, to create a new bond.
Yeah.